lead. Now the continuation of those second runs with Tony Gubber.
Egerhard Fasser in Switzerland 1. In 7th place, Kurt Meyer, Marcel Fasler and Werner Stocker. Oh, his crew, they got away in 5.23 on the first start, so they're better than that, a hundredth of a second better, and second best on this second run so far. Three quarters of a second off the leaders on the first run. 26.44, still second best. This is a man who could well move up and challenge for one of the medals. 74.9, just under 75 miles an hour. Former European and world four-man champion back in 1983. And a bronze medalist in the four-man world championships at St. Moritz last year. 5.717 would be the target time, 5.737. And a total time of 1 minute 54.2 puts Fasser into second place. But he'll have to sit and wait and see what Hoppe and Hiltebrand can do when they come down a little later. Well, the RAF sled of Tom Delahunty in 22nd place after their really disappointing first run. 31-year-old RAF PTI and parachute training instructor. And looking to Colin Rattigan, a 100-metre sprinter. George Robertson, former RAF decathlete. And Alec Leons, the brakeman, to provide the push and the power. Maybe one should say that Alec Leons, the brakeman at the back, has had a chill for the last couple of days. They only managed 5.22 on their first start compared to the 5.19 that they had done in training. 5.26, well, that's slower still. Fifth best on the second run. Delahunty, who's suffered broken collarbones, broken ribs, and a broken sternum during his bobsleigh career. Wife Heather back in Gloucester, expecting their maybe in a few days. Eighth place, 26.68. Just under 74 miles an hour. And these sleds running about 3 or 4 inches above the ice. The inside of the sleds customized to suit the crew. There's a little bit of padding here, a little bit of padding there, just to protect them in case they get a knock. And they stop the clock in 58.13, which is a total of 1 minute 55.94. And in eighth place, Delahunty will be happier with that time than he was with his first. Well, there's a terrific buzz of anticipation down this bob run with Chris Laurie in Canada 1, in bronze medal place after his first run. Now, this is the acid test. He was second sled down on the first run, had almost perfect conditions. What can he do now that the track has begun to break up a little bit? 5.23 was his first start, 5.28, only ninth best. But these Canadian crews have obviously trained here for several weeks, indeed weeks and months prior to the Olympic event. They've seen more of this track than anyone else and should know it better than anyone else. Andy Swim, Ken LeBlanc and Howard Dell, the three crewmen. He's in eighth place here, 26.63. Five-year-old Chris Laurie comes from Windsor in Ontario, wasn't chosen to ride in the two-man. Only ninth quickest on this second run, but remember he was in third place, so he's got a little bit of time to play with. 58.05, so he's lost ground. 1 minute 54.71, he's back to fifth. and with Hoppe of East Germany and Hildebrand of Switzerland to come down immediately after him, will be pushed back at least a couple more places from there. Silver medalist in the two-man, defending Olympic champion from 4 years ago in the four-man. Wolfgang Hoppe in first place after his first run, and with an advantage of about a quarter of a second over Hildebrand of Switzerland, who was in second place. Now, that's a better start than their first, 5.24. It was a 5.26 on the first run. But the aerodynamic advantage of these sleds and the skill of the drivers certainly showed itself on that first run. These drivers aren't thinking about the bend that they're on. They're thinking a bend ahead, trying to remember what comes next. Only fifth fastest on this second run, but remember, he's not had such a good draw. 35.62, well, he's improved to second. This will confirm him in first place. Slips through the labyrinth and then around bend 12, right-handed off 13, and the long finishing sweep. 5.784 is the target time for the lead. Yes, he's well inside that, half a second inside it, 57. They took it off the screen so quickly I couldn't read it, but it's a total time of 1 minute 53.47. His finishing time, 57.31. So Hoppe in first place, and he will stand at the bottom and listen to the tannoy now, as Hans Hildebrand is the next sled down. Now Hildebrand, 43. A tubby little electrician from Zurich. World two-man champion way back in 77. 5.25, they equal their first start, but the push handles are a little slow to go down. This is exactly the same crew with Hildebrand that won the four-man world championship at St. Moritz last year. Bellman, Fassbind, and the brakeman André Kaiser. Only 12th quickest, 26.65. Well, Hildebrand could drop a few places unless he picks up some speed here. 74.3. Of the 21 medals awarded in Olympic bob over the last few years, 12 of them have gone to East Germany, 5 to Switzerland. And he stops the clock in 57.91. It's not good enough by Hildebrand. He's lost ground and slipped from second to fourth. A total time of 1 minute 54.30. Great Britain won in 16th place, highest of our two sleds after the first run. Mark Tout, the driver, 29, former decathlete, Army's superstar champion in 1986 and 87. 5.31 on their first push start was a 5.28. So not quite as good this time by Lenny Paul, Audley Richards and Dave Armstrong. Tout steering with rope handles inside the cowling attached to the front runners, and there's only about 3 inches of movement in it. And he clouts the side there and there. 73.6 miles an hour. Took the back end a little high on the first part of the labyrinth. Had to undergo a 1 hour operation at Mark Tout after crashing at Lake Placid last year. And he comes down in 58.26, which is more than a second slower than his first run, 1 minute 55.48, and they are in 12th place. Well, other sleds have come down consistently half a second slower than their first run, and Mark Tout will be disappointed to be a second behind his first descent. Hal Hoy, Bill White and Michael Wasko, the three crewmen, providing the power at the back for Brent Rushlaw in joint fourth place. America's number one sled. .525, that's a hundredth of a second, better than their first start, eighth best on the second run. But if this 36-year-old caretaker from Saranac Lake can get a good drive here, he could leave the United States in a position from which they may yet challenge for a four-man medal over the final two runs tomorrow. This is his fourth Winter Games, Rushlaw. His best result was finishing sixth in the two-man at Lake Placid in 1980. Well, he's ninth best on the second run, 35.81, just under 74.5 miles an hour. Didn't finish the two-man event when he failed to make the fourth and final run, and he goes fifth, 57.67. Well, he's lost a little bit of ground. He was joint fourth, now with a total time of 1 minute 54.39. He's in fifth place, but that's still a good position for Rushlaw and still a sort of position from which he may challenge for a bronze medal.
So at the halfway point of the competition, it's still Hoppe out in front with East Germany 1, the Soviet Union moving into second place, and Switzerland 1 getting ahead of Switzerland 2. Slight improvement for the British mob.
Disappointed again, rather. So it's the third of four runs to decide the medals. Tony Gubber now reporting.
After the wind, the dust storms and the heat wave, there's a bone-hard early morning frost to end this four-man bob competition. And the ice will be hard and fast, particularly for the early starters, like Switzerland's Egerhard Fasser, the man who is in third place. And with only a second covering the top eight places, and with the overnight leader, East Germany's Wolfgang Hoppe, drawn almost last on this third run, all three medal positions could yet change. And these perfect early morning conditions giving Great Britain's Tom Delahunty a great opportunity to improve the position of Britain's second sled in 19th place at the halfway stage. And that an improvement after the first run when they were 22nd. Average age of this crew, 28. Now this sled weighs over 600 pounds, and that's what Rattigan, George Robertson and Alec Lyons are trying to get moving as quickly as possible. 5.26, second best start on this third run, but they're the fourth sled down, and we've seen that the run is possibly as much as a second quicker today than it was yesterday. This sled running about 3 inches above the ice. And the crew will feel every bump, and let's hope that Delahunty, this 31-year-old parachute instructor, doesn't have too many. He's got to keep it clean, particularly here. And almost 76 miles an hour. Well, he's a lot faster than he was yesterday. One or two Union flags in evidence today on this early morning. Now 5.781 was his best yesterday, 5.674, easily his best time, 2 minutes 52.68. And for a few brief moments, Tom Delahunty is in the top three. This is the sled in eighth place, that of Austria 1, driven by Peter Kinast. And the crewman Franz Siegel, Christian Mark, and Kurt Teigl. Punched and ready for the explosive effort. Now. And that's the best start so far on the third run, 5.21. They've been consistent, 5.19 and 5.24 on their two previous descents. This is the crew that won the World Cup four-man championship during the last winter. And silver medalist in the four-man world championships in 1986. almost 76 and a half miles an hour, so he's quicker than Delahunty was. .5707 was his best time yesterday, .5627. And Peter Kinast goes into first place with a total of 2 minutes 50.74. The sixth sled down, that of Egerhard Fasser. In third place, Kurt Meyer, Marcel Fassler, and Werner Stocker of the crew. And that 5.21 was the start of Austria's Peter Kinast, and they equal that again, 5.21, which is their best start. And you can hear the runners crackling on that really sharp ice this morning. A little after 8 o'clock and still well below freezing. It's about -4. Once the sun gets a little higher in the sky and starts to shine in the run, it will start to soften the ice and become brittle and will slow. Fasser steering a good tight line. He's easily the quickest, 46.73. This will put him top of the leaderboard. 5.654 is the target for the lead, 55.88. That is a new track record by Fasser. Total of 2 minutes 50.08, but that time 55.88 is a new track record for the 35-year-old Swiss athlete Egerhard Fasser. A third of a second quicker than the track record set yesterday by East Germany's Wolfgang Hoppe. Both starts yesterday by the sled of Jamaica 1, driven by Dudley Stokes, were, to say the least, untidy. First time, Stokes hardly got on board himself. And then the second time, the brakeman, Nelson Stokes, at the back, his younger brother, sat down so quickly that he didn't leave enough room for the third place man ahead of him to get his backside down. In fact, the crew were still trying to get themselves settled and sat as they went into the first bend. Let's see if they can do it a little better today. Well, just about, 5.32, seventh fastest. And they were in 25th place. Heads not really as neatly as aligned as on the more experienced crews. And he's getting one or two rather untidy high points on these bends. Much harder to drive these four-man sleds. Total weight of half a ton. Oh, and he's get all over the place in the Kreisel. Oh, and he's on there, he's over! Oh, dear me! Oh, that's terrible. Oh, that's a bad crash, I'm afraid. Willing hands are there quickly. And we'll have to hope that Dudley Stokes, Michael White, Devon Harris and Nelson Stokes are none the worse for that heart-stopping adventure, because he was really all over the place. Well, he was in trouble almost from the start, Dudley Stokes, this 25-year-old helicopter pilot. This is the really untidy entrance into the Kreisel. And you can see he's staying up on that wall far too long, and in the end, he just drops off. There's nowhere to go. And that's a very nasty collision. Shower of sparks and ice. And that whole sled, half a ton, completely out of control. And what a satisfaction it is to be able to see that all four members of that Jamaican crew are now on their feet and able to walk down to the finish house. But that's the end of their Olympic adventure. They've brought sunshine and smiles and their own brand of reggae music. A disappointment for them, I'm sure, that they're not able to complete the event. but maybe they should just be thankful that they're able to walk away. Bill? It's meant quite a long delay for Ingo Appelt, the driver of Austria 2, to wait at the top. This the sled in seventh place at the halfway stage. The track now repaired and clear for the competition to continue. Now, 5-2-6 was his best start yesterday. Josef Moog, Gerhard Redl and Harald Winkler, the crew. And that's their best start, 5.24, fourth quickest on the third run so far. And this is the man who won the World Cup two-man winter series. Over 76 miles an hour and third fastest so far. And they stop the clock in 56.41. 2 minutes 50.85 and they go into third place. Powerful squat figure of Yanis Kipors of the Soviet Union, gold medalist from the two-man, and in second place at the halfway stage of this four-man event, Guntis Osis, Yuri Tone and Vladimir Kozlov are the crew, being rather heavily slapped on the back. A little bit of final massage, muscle toning. ...5.21 has been the fastest start so far on this third run. He's been faster than that on his two previous runs. 5.18 and 5.19. Yes, and that's the best start so far today. 5.20 for the 30-year-old student of PE from Moscow. Fourth fastest, he's lost that early advantage. A little bit of a touch there in the accelerating straight, but it's over 76 miles an hour, 76.2. And Kipors was just over half a second behind the leader, Hoppy, after the first two runs. Only fifth fastest on this third descent. But remember, Hoppy has to wait even longer before he comes down, 56.41. Total of 2 minutes 50.41, and that is only good enough for second place, which means that Kippers has lost ground. He goes behind Egerhard Fasser, who was third at the halfway stage, and Kippers moved from silver medal position back to bronze. Well, already signs that the track is beginning to slow a little now, the sun higher, as Mark Tout, the driver of Great Britain 1, prepares to make his third descent. Lenny Paul, Audley Richards and Dave Armstrong, the crew.
Good, and up. Good. One, two, three. Yeah!
Now they were in 14th place. Best position of the British sleds at the halfway stage. 5.28 has been their best start and they equal that, 5.28. Difficult to avoid the feeling that the dissension among the British bobsleigh crew over the selection of the drivers for this four-man, which brought simmering resentments to the surface, has made itself felt in this four-man, in which there were real expectations that we could get into the top 10. 75.4 miles an hour. only 13th quickest. 5.722 was his best yesterday, 5.686. Total of 2 minutes 52.34 puts Mark Tout in 12th place, and that ought to be good enough for him to hold on to 14th place when this third round is completed. He's just ahead of Great Britain 2, which is currently 13th. Now this, the crew, in 4th place at the halfway stage, Hans Hiltebrand in Switzerland 2, the tubby Zurich electrician. Average age of this crew, 32. It's the oldest sled in the race. And they get away in 5.27, only the 12th fastest. And Hiltebrand, remember, winner of so many world championships, still looking for his first Olympic medal. And this is his last opportunity. Only 14th fastest, 26.33. The sunlight now bright in several places on the track. And 75.4 miles an hour, and it's bright on the Kreisel as well. And all these sleds have been coming down marginally slower. Since the early start has enjoyed those perfect conditions. 55.78 is the time that he would need to go into the lead, and he's lost a lot of ground. He's back to 8th place. Total of 2 minutes 51.43. Sir Hiltebrand is way off the medals. And that surely is now the end of his ambition to become an Olympic medalist. Well, one wonders at the thoughts in the mind of Wolfgang Hoppe of East Germany 1, who led the competition at the halfway stage. He's been really critical of this track. Little clenched fists there, indicating his determination. But if the track is getting slower, and the signs are over the last few sets that it is, then it's down to how big an effort he can get from Schauerhammer, Musiol and Vogue, and then how well he can drive. 5.26, that's only the 10th best start on this third run. Lost his gold medal in the two-man event, had to settle for silver here, having taken gold in Sarajevo, and defending champion in the four-man as well. Now he starts this third run with a half a second advantage over Kippers, who was second at the halfway stage, and three quarters of a second over Egerhard Fasser, who was third. But remember, they came down much earlier, and he's only 10th quickest. Well, he'll improve obviously from that, because he's got quite a lot of time to play with. But the question will be, how much is the gap closed, and will he hold on to top place? 47.35, 12th fastest. This big, powerful 30-year-old former international decathlete. And he's lost top place, 56.77. He's off top spot and into second with a total of 2 minutes 50.24. And it's Fasser in Switzerland 1 who leads. Hoppe back into silver medal place. But on the fourth and final run, he is drawn for a better start. Once again, the medal positions have changed with one more run to come. Now Egerhard Fasser leading by 16-tenths of a second from the man trying to defend the gold medal, Wolfgang Hoppe of East Germany, and Janis Kippers of the Soviet Union, who took gold in the two-man in bronze medal place. And the British sleds are 15th and 16th.
And the Jamaican team, who survived a nasty accident earlier, didn't finish the third run and don't go again. Tony Gubber now reports.
Well, every position changed in this four-man event after the third run, which just shows how much the medals will be influenced here in Calgary by the starting order. And Maris Poikens of the Soviet Union in seventh place with this fourth and final run to make has the advantage of being the second sled down. And the sun is getting higher, it's getting warmer, and the track is beginning to deteriorate. Joint seventh, just over a second behind the leader, and they get away in 5.19. Their starts have been so consistent from this crew. He was sixth at the halfway stage. He lost one place because he didn't have too good a draw on the third run. But if it cuts up as much on this fourth and final run as it did on the third, then the advantage of going early like this may prove to be decisive. Could easily improve from seventh into a medal position, 35.36, first on this final run at this stage, just under 75 miles an hour. And as you can see, he's over half a second beyond the time that he needs to go into the lead, 57.24, total of 3 minutes 48.35. And Poikens goes into first place. A big opportunity for Brent Rushlaw in the United States number one sled in sixth place. Again, bare knuckles. Hal Hoy, Bill White, Michael Wasko got away in a 5.28 on their third run, and Sindler again, 5.27. Really need a start about 600ths or so quicker than that. USA 14 bends on this bob run. The gradient at its steepest is about 1 in 6. This is bend 7 and then quickly 8, where other crews have had trouble. Nice clean line, just over 75 miles an hour. 20.9 kilometers an hour. And he stops the clock in 57.20, which puts Rushlaw in first place, 3 minutes 48.28. They're happy with it. That pushes Poikens back to second.
Good. And up. Good. 1, 2, 3.
Now we're looking for a big effort from Mark Tout's crew. They're way back in 15th place, but going quite early on this fourth and final descent. 5.29 is their second slowest of the three descents they've already made. This is the Army sled. Great Britain 2, remember, is the RAF sled of Tom Delahunty. The 29-year now, marked out, likes to be known as Stan. Under 75 miles an hour, and the sunlight's really bright in the Kreisel. Finished 18th in the two-man event a week ago, and 57.56. Total of 3 minutes 49.9, and Tout temporarily is in third place. The final Olympic appearance for Hans Hildebrand. He's in ninth place. Same crew that won the four-man world championships at St. Moritz in 1987. And the fifth fastest start on this fourth run. Louis Fellman, Irvin Fassbind, and André Kaiser are Hildebrand's crew. And the career of this great bobsleigh driver would have been complete if he could have collected an Olympic medal here in Calgary. Just under 74 and a half miles an hour. Unless there's a truly dramatic deterioration in the track, more than we've seen already, Hildebrand is going to finish just outside the medals. 57.82. Total time of 3 minutes 49.25 in third place, but he will be moved back from there. Almost certainly within the next 60 seconds. And at the top of the run, Wolfgang Hoppe. He led after the first two runs, was pushed back to second after a late start in that third run, now with the advantage of going early on this fourth and final descent. They don't hang about, they pick up the sled, it's over £600, and they've got to get as much acceleration and momentum into it as possible at the start. 5.23, second best start, only Poikens of the Soviet Union was quicker than that. Double gold medalist 4 years ago, a silver from the two man this time. And it needs skill and strength, concentration and reflexes. And not surprisingly, he's the quickest so far on this fourth run. Dived off that bend eight, just over 74 and a half miles an hour. He's got Dietmar Schauerhammer, Bogdan Musiol and Ingo Vogue in the crew with him. Well, he's only third quickest at that stage. 58.04, he's inside that, 57.34. Total of 3 minutes 47.58, sufficient at this stage to put 30-year-old Wolfgang Hoppe, the East German army officer, into first place. But Fasser, who led after the third run, has yet to come down. Well, they were 13th after the first run, 11th after the second, and 7th, rather, as they start this final descent. Detlef Richter in East Germany 1. Now, 5.19 has been their best, 5.27 is their worst start. Bronze and silver medalist in the World Two-Man Championships, and a bronze medal in the Olympic four-man in Lake Placid. Now 33, Richter, an army captain and former athlete. One of the fastest men in training, but he didn't manage to produce that sort of form in the event itself. 5.647 is his target time for the lead, 5.7.95 into fourth place with 3 minutes 49.06. And no medals this time for the sled of East Germany 2. Now, when the three-man crew of Great Britain 2 hunch at the back behind driver Tom Dillahunty, it looks like a rugby union front row. Colin Rattigan immediately behind Dillahunty. Then the brakeman in the middle there, Alec Leonce. And on the far side, George Robertson. As you could hear Dillahunty, you've got to give it. 5.22 was the best start. Although remember, they did a 5.19 in that race off for selection. Oh, he looks so he's limping there, Dillahunty. Well, he's got on board all right. 5.30, that's their slowest start. That was a nasty little crack on the left-hand side at the end of that start. But Tom Dillahunty, the 31-year-old RAF PTI, didn't look to be running flat out on that push start, and looked to me as though he had trouble with one of his ankles. 13th fastest, 26.61. Keeps a nice clean line down the accelerating straight, just under 73 miles an hour. Remember, he began this final run in 16th place. He's 13th fastest so far. And he finishes in 58.59 as Leons pulls on the brakes. Total of 351.27. In 10th place at this stage, he'll have to wait and see how far he gets pushed back from that position by the sleds which have yet to come. The hunched figure of Peter Kinast driving Austria 1. They're in fourth place, just outside the medals. And you have to go back to 1968 in Grenoble for the last time Austria took an Olympic bobsleigh medal, and that was a silver in the four-man. The second time that they'd done that, and there's been nothing since in either two or four. But Kinast, 38, an electrical engineer, he's only just outside the medal places. Well, he's the fastest sled down so far on this fourth run. Faster than Wolfgang Hoppe was, but remember, Hoppe had a big time advantage over Kinast. The question is, how much can he erode that? Franz Siegel, Christian Mark and Kurt Teigl are the crew, all athletes. Five, six, eight, four is his target time. He's outside that, 57.91. It's only fourth place for Kinast, and so there is to be no medal for Austria in this event. Gave himself a chance on the early part of this course, which is just under a mile in length, when he was enjoying the fastest run, but he lost it on the bottom half and goes into fourth place. Now, this is the man who leads the competition, Egerhard Fasser, 35-year-old Swiss athlete. Kurt Meyer, Marcel Fasler, Werner Stocker, the crew. And he gets away in 5.17. Well, that's inspirational. The quickest start. And remember, he has a lead in gold medal position of about 16-tenths of a second. Hoppy's already gone, he leads the competition. Still first, this is a gold medal run for Fasser. Bronze medalist in the four-man at St. Moritz in the World Championships in 1987. And a former European and world four-man champion back in 1983. And he's over 74 miles an hour. And it looks as though Hoppe is going to have to settle for silver again. Well, he's lost it, he's 47.68. Again, he's not driving the bottom half of the course as well as the top, and maybe that's because the sun's shining more on the bottom half. And he does it, 57.43, 0.07 of a second. 3 minutes, 47.51. And the Swiss can celebrate. Fasser and his crew already out to celebrate a gold medal. Hoppe's pushed back into silver. And what an adventurous ride. A great start. 5.17. What a time to produce a start like that. With the Swiss celebrating gold at the bottom of the bob run, some 400 feet further down the mountain, the last sled to come down, that of the Soviet Union, Yanis Kipors, was in bronze medal position after the third run. And this is the last sled in this Olympic event and the last sled which can now affect the medal positions. He was exactly a third of a second behind Fasser after the third run. Surely he can't make that up now. The track is pitted and rutted. But can Kippers hold on to bronze and deny that medal for America's Brent Rushlaw? And they get away in a start time of 5.15. What a time to do that, equaling the track record. He asked for a big effort from the crew, and this 30-year-old student of PE certainly got it. Now let's look for the splits here. Remember, he was a third of a second behind Fassa, and he's only fourth quickest. 26.15, so the bronze medal is hanging by the narrowest of margins. And back to six. European gold medalist in 1984, fourth in the World Four-Man Championships in 1987, gold medalist in the two-man, and Kipper's off the final bend, and he gets the bronze, 57.85. A total time of 3 minutes, 48.26. Kipper's just doing enough on the very last run to hold on to the bronze medal position and to push the American driver Brent Rushlaw back to fourth. And so the medal's confirmed. It's gold for Fassa of Switzerland, as they knew. Hoppe of East Germany again has to settle for silver, as he did in the two-man event. And Kippers, who took gold in the two-man, has bronze in the four-man. And that was a terrific drive on the very last sled in the competition to hold on to that third place.
Final positions. Delahunty, the driver of GB2, who you saw limping at the start of the push there, tore a hamstring on the previous run, and that was why he was limping. Hence he was 17th, and Britain's other crew were 12th in the end. There's some